for two consecutive terms has led to violence in the form of demonetization, farmer suicides, lynching of Dalit and Muslim persons, and Kashmir being stripped of.
This is my first pride.
And what is, how do you feel?
It's really crowded. I'm so happy to be here. There are a lot of posters against CAA and NRC, and the venue couldn't have been better, because in Bengal they're trying to encroach, create problems, create unrest, and this neighborhood is one of the areas where they sort of try and do it mostly.
It's immense significance in the wake of what the country is going through right now. And the Pride has always been a very political space. So here we are to sort of talk about the intersection of queer lives, and queer lives that are not being lived in vacuum, but queer lives that have been affected by the NPR process, the Citizens Amendment, Citizen Amendment Act. So it is a very, very interesting stage at which the Kolkata Pride, the oldest pride in India, is sort of taking place today, which is also a site, as much as it is for celebration, it is also a site of protest and registering our dissent and upholding democratic values in this country that is being threatened.
It is the 20th year of Kolkata Pride. So over the years, what changes have you seen?
Well, for one, for sure, more number of people. Visibly, there's been a shift. And also, the fact that the Pride sort of takes place in the city at multiple locations over the years. This location, for example, is a very interesting location. This is also one of the most densely populated part of the city. It is also one of the arterial roads. We haven't held a pride here. So more number of people, the spontaneous participation of allies. So the lines are very, very blurred. You never know who's queer, who's not queer. We're all here to support what the Pride stands for.
The kind of problems we are facing is in the unity within our community. All the united voice needs to be heard, and that's why we are out today at the Kolkata Rainbow Pride Walk. We are there to make a lot of noise, to fight for ourselves, our rights, but not only ours, but all the minorities. We protest against the NRC, the CAA. We refuse the trans bill because this goes against the ethos of our constitution.
Faced by trans individuals when they go to a government health sector, okay, they can't discuss the problem freely, or they feel too shy to it, or they feel they're not properly cared for. I think we should tend to these problems more. Also, there are a lot of individuals in the LGBTQ community who are living with depression and a lot of mental issues. I think those things should be abandoned. I think people don't have any idea of any LGBTQ friendly psychologist or psychiatrist in the city. They have no idea where to go, what to do with them. So I think we should send to them, organize a health camp where we can bring all the LGBTQ people under one roof and tend to their problems. That's going to be a starting point.
Happy Pride, Shabai! Step one is the word.